Chick-fil-A offers our ultimate.
Portland Wrestling is brought to you by Tom Peterson.
You're an ignorant son of a gun then, and you're bloody worse now, because it looks like you put on a few pounds.
You're just lucky that you're not wrestling me tonight in that square circle.
Well, you must go to Las Vegas a lot, because you don't know how bloody lucky you are. And I'll tell you another bloody thing. There's nothing stopping me having two matches here tonight, so you get back and sign anything you want. You understand that? Because I'll never back down from a big, fat slob like you, Mr. Rose Garden, Buddy Rose.
Oh, mercy.
Buddy Rose, or anybody back there that's watching a monitor, I'm challenging you all.
And we're just getting started. Oh, we'll be right back with all the action right after this. Don't go away.
Only at Tom Peterson's will you find super service. Free delivery today. Free installation today. Free removal today. Free 30-day home trial. Your choice. RCA Sharp Zenith 25-inch color TVs, only $397. Your choice. Sealy, Spring Air, Simmons, queen-size bedding set, only $198. Or no interest, no carrying charges till March 1990 on any of these Magic Chef appliances. Choose this washer dryer pair, $498. This built-in dishwasher, $297. This 30-inch electric range, $267. Your choice 10-foot upright or chest freezer, $297. Choose this 17 no-frost refrigerator, $498. Now that's Tom Peterson, the happy place to buy. It's worth the trip.
It's hard to imagine when you're trying to do a remodel what it's going to look like, and it's nice to walk in there and get an idea of how you want your kitchen.
When we went through the showcase, you could see all the different cabinets that we could have bought, and we really wanted to get this European look.
Right now, you'll save 65% off the manufacturer's list price on complete pay-and-pack kitchens.
Well, I especially like the people that live there. I think they are so supportive, you know, first-name basis. When we left, they were calling me Dottie, and I was calling them Bob, and they are doing something right, and I hope they never change it.
Vancouver, Portland, we've got what you need. The biggest selection and the lowest payment ever. This weekend, Vancouver Ford's got over 150 89 Ford Rangers and Escorts. Plus, we'll cut your payments in half. Choose from over 75 new Ford Escorts. Just $79 a month for the first year, $158 a month thereafter.
Use your rebate as your down payment.
Choose Sporty Ranger S. Just $89 a month for 1 year, then $178 thereafter. This special purchase event ends Monday at Vancouver, Portland's only 5-star Ford dealer, Vancouver Ford.
Here's Don Owen. Make the first announcement of our first match.
The Latin Lover is now approaching the ring.
There he is, Al Madrill, coming into the arena. Catching the verbal abuse of the crowd. Yeah, lay it on him, lay it on him.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The first event this evening will be One Fall. Introducing in this corner, 240 pounds from Los Angeles, the Latin Lover, Al Madrill. His opponent in this corner, 233 pounds from Florida, Rex King. The referee, Sandy Barr.
This place is coming unglued already, and I thought we were going to have our first match during our introduction with Lord Jonathan Boyd, and then Buddy Rose came in there, and oh, mercy. This place is packed. We love to see that. Everybody is here tonight. I understand that Donnie Miller's here. He's having a happy birthday. And look, up here in the crow's nest, we got Bill Prescott from KGON, number one in his time slot and number one in your time slot. They're all here tonight. Listen, the crowd already getting on Al Madrill, the Latin Lover, as he likes to be called. Some people call him the Fireman. Others have names for him that we can't repeat. on family television here. Stay right where you are. Don't you dare go away. Don't touch that dial. We are going to explode with more professional wrestling action you've ever seen before than you'll ever see anywhere in the world of professional wrestling or professional wrestling or whatever it is. Right here at the House of Action, the Portland Sports Arena. Al Madrill strutting around cockily and Rex King. Rex King, the rookie of the year in the state of Florida. He's a rookie, but I'll tell you, he doesn't have very many rookie moves. He's learning very rapidly. There's a rake across the back, another rake across the back. Of course, he has drawn right now one of the slyest, most unpredictable wrestlers in Al Madrill. Down goes, look at that leapfrog by Rex King. Oh, man, he about jumped out of the building. There's another one. Oh, beautiful move. That's not a rookie move, nor is that. Drop kick out of the ring and on his face goes Al Madrill. That's not a rookie move, my friend. That's Rex King in action. Yes, sir. Later on tonight will not be on TV. That match that the entire Northwest, in fact, I understand they're talking about this coast to coast. Carl Stiles, the student, takes on the grappler, the teacher. And this thing, you saw that this thing's been boiling. And finally, Carl Stiles standing up, speaking for himself, and he's going to speak with action tonight against the grappler. And I still can't believe what happened last Saturday night. A good friendship came to an end with Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson. Clothesline, a short clothesline by Al Madrill, caught Rex King completely off guard, also caught him right in the throat, and he's gasping for breath as he takes a hard shot right in the middle of the forehead. And Rex King now trying to gather his thoughts, got cobwebs in his head right now, backing up against the turnbuckle. Here comes a forearm smash across the chest by Al Madrill on Rex King. There goes a whip into the other turnbuckle. Here comes Madrill, and that is not a rookie move either. As Rex King moved out of the way, Madrill cut that turnbuckle full force on the left shoulder. Side headlock, and wait a minute, what did he take out of the tights? He took that lighter out of his tights again. He flicked his pick right into the throat of Rex King. The man has a weapon. It's a lighter that he takes out of his, sometimes he hides it in the tights, sometimes he hides it in his boot. We've caught it on camera. Everybody on this side of the ring knows what's going on. But, of course, he's out of the sight of referee Sandy Barr. Rex King still trying to get his breath after taking that shot right in the throat as Al Madrill used that lighter as a weapon. Now he's got him outside again. A hard pop right in the middle of the forehead, and Rex King is down. The action outside the ring right now. A hard stomp. Al Madrill gets in, breaks the count. That count had reached 20. This one had been all over. This is our first match tonight from the House of Action. We're just getting started. There is tension. There is excitement in the air. There's something in the air that you can cut with a knife. And it's starting right out there in the middle of the ring. And as Rex King finds himself out on the mat again, outside on the floor, and Al Madrill receives a stern warning from referee Sandy Barr, which undoubtedly will fall on deaf ears. Rex King grabs the leg of Al Madrill, going to wrap it around that post. Yes, sir. I'll tell you one thing. The post wins every time on this one. Left leg. Going to do the right leg. Al Madrill's not going to have a leg to stand on. I can tell you right now. And, oh, mercy, mercy. Al Madrill now singing tenor. We'd like to be 10 or 12 blocks away right now. Rex King bringing the crowd to their feet and bringing Al Madrill to his seat out there on the floor. He finally gets to his feet, trying to make it to the ring. He is hurting. I'll tell you right now, that man is in pain, and he's suffering a little bit of embarrassment, too, taking a pretty good beating from a rookie, Rex King, begging for mercy. Don't fall for this one, Rex. Don't fall for this one. Either shake hands with that guy. All right. Shake hands, plants a boot in the midsection. There goes Madrill into the ropes. Back body drop by Rex King. And Al Madrill is hurting. He is really hurting. Down he goes. A drop kick. A clothesline by Rex King. The man learns fast, does he not? 1-2, and Madrill kicks out. Rex King is staying on this guy like glue. Wait a minute. What did Madrill take out of those tights? He's got that lighter again into the throat. He's got the lighter. Now he puts it in the boot, crying out loud. Al Madrill feeling very sure. Look at this. Referee found the lighter. Referee Sandy Barr found the lighter in the boot, pulled the lighter out, and this baby's over. Al Madrill has been disqualified, as he should be, And he got caught red-handed. Yes, indeed. Uh-huh. He tried to use a match in this match, and one of the matches was a lighter. And the winner by disqualification, Rex King over Al McGrill. We've got more. We'll be back with more right after this timeout.
Only at Tom Peterson's. Super service means free 30-day home trial. At Tom Peterson's, if you're not completely happy with your purchase, bring it back for an exchange, a different model, or a refund. At Tom Peterson's, it's not yours until you like it. Our only job is keeping you happy. And here's
that's Tom Peterson's.
Carl Stiles, you've got the biggest match of your life tonight, but it looks like you've got some very good support in Top Gun and some special guests.
You know, Carl Stiles, you know, every week, you know, for the last 3 or 4 weeks, I look, and we've been looking up to you. We got these little girls and all these fans out there, and what we want to know, Carl, is why do you let a man like the Grappler, you let him keep slapping you, you let him slap you around, and you got us sort of confused, you know, because these little girls, me, the Southern Rockers, we look up to you, man. All these people, we look up to you. We need to know, Carl, what, are you with us? Are you with us? Are you with these little girls who look up to you, who look up to a man, Carl Stiles, who's been getting slapped around? Are you finally snapping out of it? Are you going to do the thing, man? That's what we want to know. The little girls want to know. All these great fans, everybody out there in TV land.
Well, I sure didn't want to let nobody down, and I always wanted to have, you know, respect for my elders and the Grappler. He was my teacher and my coach, but I didn't want to let these kids down, and I sure am sorry that I let anybody down, and I just ain't going to be slapped no more, though. That Grappler, he's not going to slap me again.
All right! So what you're saying? What you're saying, Carl Stiles? It doesn't matter if it's Pendleton, Oregon, LeGrand, Baker, Ontario, Burns, Eugene, we're going to be hopping and popping. You're going to be snapping necks. We're going to be getting down all over the Northwest. All right!
All right. Carl Stiles standing up for himself and for his fans.
This is what it's all about, baby.
Hey, I ain't gonna let nobody slap me around no more.
All right, we'll be right back with more after this timeout.
Dusting can be beautiful.
For 28 years and counting.
The next event will be one fall. Introducing in this corner, 238 pounds from Tennessee, gorgeous Joey Jackson. His opponent in this corner, 248 pounds, the Top Gun.
All right, people, right now, the gorgeous one. That's what that said on the back of that robe. Gorgeous Joey Jackson and the Top Gun. Right, so this plate, boy, I tell you, we got banners, we got flags, we got signs all over the place. People have been asking, hey, where's Scotty the Body? Well, he's here. He's here. Nice hip toss by Joey Jackson. He'll be joining us up here in the crow's nest sooner than we really... care to even think about it. But yes, Scotty the Body will be here live and in mouth. Yeah, he's out loading up on grapes or something. All right, Top Gun, Joey Jackson. I tell you, they were talking about Pendleton. That's where they're going to be tomorrow. Pendleton, look out, coming your way tomorrow at the Armory, 7 o'clock. Tickets at the doors. Open starts at 6. Tickets open, the door open at 6. Matches start at 7. Monday the 20th in LeGrand at the Armory, starting at 8. Look out, here comes Joey. Down goes Top Gun. Oh, Top Gun waiting for him. And he landed right on his gorgeous. There's another one. And he's going to drag the entire body out of the ring. Tuesday the 21st in Baker at the Armory, starting at 8 o'clock. Wednesday the 22nd in Ontario at the Armory, 8 o'clock bell time. Thursday the 23rd in Burns. Oh, we're going to light up Burns start in the Armory, starting at 8 o'clock. This is the crowd. Crowd loves Top Gun. Really behind him. And gorgeous Joey suffering an arm bar right now at the hands of Top Gun. Top Gun can bring the elbow down. Crowd says, go for it, TG. Uh-oh, and while he was looking, he got it reversed on him. And now it's Joey Jackson with an arm bar on Top Gun. And you're going to stretch that arm out, twist the wrist back in a manner that's not... Oh, man, look what he's doing the fingers. He's ripping those fingers apart, too. Thursday the 23rd, Burns at the Armory at 8. Friday the 24th, Eugene at the Fairgrounds starting at 8 o'clock. What a match they got scheduled. If there's anything left to Styles and the Grappler after tonight, they're going to meet in Eugene on Friday the 24th. Good shoulder tackle by Joey Jackson. Over goes Joey. Oh, and he just ran into a hard clothesline from Top Gun. And Joey Jackson, I tell you, has been hung out to dry right now by Top Gun. Top Gun getting the crowd pumped, getting them going. An elbow right on top of the head. Joey is rocking. He's reeling. He's down. Joey Jackson, man, he took a couple of elbows right on top of the head. There's a flying mare. And Jackson reverses and got a hammerlock on Top Gun right now. Next Saturday, of course, right back here at the Portland Sports Arena. And later on in the month, Monday the 27th, McMinnville at the Armory. Tuesday the 28th, have a big special at the Portland Sports Arena. We're going to tell you more about that in just a little bit. But mark it down, Tuesday, March 28th, the Portland Sports Arena. Joey Jackson trying to pulverize that left shoulder and arm of Top Gun into the turnbuckle. And, man, I tell you, that not only will buckle your turn, it'll do some damage on your arm, too. And he's doing it right now. Joey Jackson is working over that left arm of Top Gun, working on the shoulder, working on the bicep, working on the elbow. And now he's got a hold of the hair as he forearm smash across the chest. There goes a reversal whip. And in the turnbuckle goes Jackson. And Jackson moves. And again, that left shoulder of Top Gun takes a beating right into the turnbuckle. Jackson creating a weak spot now. Jackson creating a weak spot, as any good professional wrestler will do. And if there isn't a weak spot on his opponent, you create one and you work on it. You wear him down and you beat him and you get your money and get out of here. That's the name of the game. That's the name of that tune. Now, oh, can you hear what the crowd is yelling? They're yelling, Joey sucks. And I tell you, they're getting Joey's attention, too. And they are really behind Top Gun. No doubt about it. Top wrist lock now by Top Gun. By the way, we have a new ticket outlet. You folks might want to mark this down. The 82nd Avenue Pawn Shop. The 82nd Avenue Pawn Shop. They're located at 10309 Southeast 82nd Avenue. You can get your tickets for our matches Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. Ah, Top Gun coming back, and Jackson is down. Jackson, he's seeing some stars right now, and he's also seeing a right hand come blazing right inside of his face. Oh, man, I tell you that. Jackson comes back with a right boot. Top Gun comes back with a left one. Top Gun into the ropes. Top Gun into the other side. Over goes Top Gun, and he's... Oh, Jackson grabs him. Through the ropes he goes. Top Gun lands with a thud outside on the floor. And TG trying to think this one over as Joey Jackson parades around in the middle of the ring, showing off the forearm smash across the chest. Here comes another one across the chest. Jackson going over to the other side of the ropes, and a hard smash right in the landed that knee into the small of the back, and Top Gun hit the ground. And he hit the mat hard out there. It's a very thin mat over concrete, and the concrete does not give at all. And Top Gun coming in with a shoulder. Coming in with a victory roll. Sunset flip. One, two. He's got him hooked in. He's got it. Yes, sir. Top Gun. One, two, three. The winner. In an instant, he keeps it exploded on Jackson. Top Gun over Joey Jackson. We'll be back with more. In fact, we'll be back with the Rose Garden right after this.
59. That's Tom Peterson's.
The Rose Garden is back. Playboy Buddy Rose is back. And I want to thank Rentown USA for the comfortable chairs and especially this big recliner. Tammy, you did a great job. I want to thank Quality Floors for the beautiful flowers from Orchards, Washington. Tammy, you did a hell of a job. All right. Now, my guest tonight, if he's here, is Rowdy Roddy Piper. But, Roddy Piper, I don't see you, so I'll tell you what. If you're that chicken, I'm going to have another special guest. I knew you wouldn't show up. I'd like to introduce a great wrestler in his own way, Scotty the Body.
Hey, buddy, good to see you. How you been, brother?
Doing great. Have a chair.
Certainly.
Scotty, let's talk about, you know, I saw last week on television, they played on television, they called you Snotty the Body.
Hey, I'll tell you what, this snotty nonsense is ridiculous. They're trying to frame me, they're trying to pin the thing on me. I want you to show the tape that exonerates me, buddy.
That's right, there's a special tape. Let's look at the tape right now.
A lot of action throughout the Northwest, huh, Scotty?
What?
Huh?
Yeah. What do you want, Dave?
Not a thing, Snotty.
Look at that, buddy. You saw the tape. It's obvious. That's not my finger. That finger was superimposed. You know, who's ever doing this kind of trick photography, I'm not going to stand for it, buddy, because that's not me. I didn't do that. And I'm totally appalled, buddy.
I know you didn't do it. You're one of the greatest commentators in wrestling today. You're one of the greatest wrestlers in wrestling today. And not only that, you're going to be one of the greatest referees in wrestling.
Well, you're only saying that, buddy, because it's true. But I am going to be one of the greatest referees tonight, because tonight I'm refereeing one of the greatest matches these people will ever see, Scott Peterson against Steve Dahl.
Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't we call out the contestants right now? Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson. Hey, you two guys came here to wrestle each other. You could not settle it by just having a conversation.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, that was the original plan, but if Scott and I, if there's any way we can get out of it, we just do not wrestle each other tonight.
Well, in other words, that's a chicken way of saying it.
Oh, there's nothing chicken about it. We had some differences last week. We got a little hot-headed. We got some things
we didn't want to say.
That's right, baby. You know, we're like brothers. Everything happens even in families. We worked it all out. Everything's
fine. Hey, wait a minute. Are these guys trying to weasel out us? You know, there was a contract sign, fellas.
We ain't trying to weasel out of nothing.
Hey, buddy, there was a contract sign. I handed it to you earlier.
There's a contract sign. Not only that. You're in Pendleton tomorrow, you're in LeGrand on Monday, you're in Baker on Tuesday, you're in Ontario on Wednesday, you're in Burns on Thursday, Eugene Friday, Saturday, Portland, and there's 8-man tags in Baker, Ontario, and Burns. Now let me ask you a question. Are you going to be a tag team, or are you going to be wrestling against each other?
Why don't you show up at the arena in all these towns and find out, Buddy Rose?
We're not worried about these towns right yet. We're worried about tonight. You guys signed a contract. Are we going to get the match or what?
You know, hey, I'll tell you what. We signed a contract. Me and Scott have never reneged, or we've never backed out of it.
We don't want to wrestle each other.
But I'll tell you what, we'll do it. We'll have a good side to the match. The name on the marquee is wrestling, baby. Right. That's what we do best. The Southern Rockers do best. We'll do it there in the middle of the ring.
Personally, I hope both of you hurt each other and put yourselves in the hospital and be the end of you once and for all.
You know something, Buddy Rose? I know exactly why you want that, because you don't want to see us get those tag team titles for a sixth consecutive time, baby. This is going to be a big tag team tournament coming up. We plan on winning those belts back one more time.
And you think you're going to be in the tag team tournament? No way. Are you going to call this match fair and square?
Hey, I'm the least biased person that anyone in Portland has ever seen, and I will call this match by the book, fair and square, cross my heart.
You heard it from the Rose Garden. Just when you think you got all the answers, I changed the questions.
Look at This is crowd here, and joining us in the crow's nest, my co-host, ladies and gentlemen, everybody was wondering, well, where's Scotty the Body?
Hey, don't you worry where I've been, Cos. It's my business, and you don't have to worry about it.
Well, I thought maybe you're out getting a nose job or something.
Oh, that's funny, Cos. That's very funny, Cos.
Hey, I saw that tape.
So what's the next match, Cos? What's the lineup here?
I'll tell you what, you know it's always rocking, it's always shaking at the House of Action. Look out now, because we got a maniac coming in here, not this man here, that's Lord Jonathan Boyd. Right behind him, none other than Matt Bourne. Are you ready for this?
You know who Jonathan Boyd looks like? He looks like Ming the Merciless on Flash Gordon. And in fact, he's got a little Flash Gordon jacket on, too.
Well, why don't you tell the man that sometime, when you're out there, when you have a chance, just tell the man that.
Because he probably wouldn't understand me. He speaks that broken English.
There he is, Lord Jonathan Boyd.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a pile of action coming up in the sports arena for the next several months. And so we're going to have, keep in mind that we're every Saturday night, and we're going to have a real wild card down here, so don't fail to miss any of these. We had Matt Bourne coming down this evening to meet Kangaroo Jonathan Boyd, but Matt Bourne, who is in the building, says that he has an upset stomach and he has a stomach ache and didn't want to go on now.
What do you mean he's got a bloody upset stomach? Listen here, he's got a yellow streak up his back, but I don't care. I come to wrestle anybody that's in that other dressing room so they can send anybody there out, because I'm not leaving the ring until I wrestle.
Look out, look out. Now, those kind of words.
Buddy Rose said something about...
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, you got to be kidding. Not this guy. Not this guy.
You what?
This guy should be...
That Nord the Barbarian that I've heard around, he'll do. Get him in the ring. I'll wrestle him.
No. No, you don't want this guy.
Looks like he's coming in the ring whether you want him or not.
Oh, no, Jonathan Boyd, you don't want this guy. This guy's crazy. This man is insane. He should be locked up. Lord Jonathan Boyd and Nord the Barbarian. How did they get this guy back here? I thought we were through with him. The Barbarian is an animal, and he's going into the turnbuckle now, and he lands a big boot in the beard of Lord Jonathan Boyd. Barbarian all over Boyd. Boyd doesn't know what he's done in there. He doesn't know this guy. This man is crazy. He has done more body damage to more wrestlers over just the past couple of 3 weeks than any 10 men in here before. I'm talking from experience here, folks. He just throws Jonathan Boyd down. This man is big. He's powerful. He's a giant. Well, the giant, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. That's sometimes on their knees. Jonathan Boyd lefts and rights, and Barbarian smashing back with big right hand meat hooks. And Boyd doing what he can. I'll tell you, he's given up a lot of size, a lot of height, a lot of weight. This man is a giant. Barbarian is a giant. Now he's got a beard lock on Jonathan Boyd and a hard forearm smash. The man is, he's insane. Look at this guy. He just pulverizes his opponent. He doesn't even care if he wins. He just wants to hurt. Look at that. An entire body smash on Boyd. And Boyd, I tell you, this man has been around the world a few times. He's been around the wrestling ring a few thousand times. He's got some tricks up his sleeve, including the old fighting of the nose. Yes, sir. He about took the nose off of Nord the Barbarian. And now he's fighting him on the leg. Oh, Jonathan Boyd. Jonathan Boyd resorting and reverting back to some of the old kangaroo tricks. Yes, sir. He's gouging and biting and slashing, and outside he goes. Barbarian's right there with him. This fight could end up out in the parking lot, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this Barbarian just kicking and smashing. Oh, man, he caught Boyd right in the head. His head snapped back and hit the ring, and now he smashes him into the guardrail. Boyd is down. He is hurt. This can't go on. This guy, it takes 2 to 3 men to fight this giant Nord the Barbarian. This guy, I don't know what in the world he's doing here. I thought he was out of here. He smashes Boyd into the iron post. I don't know, Boyd is just semi-conscious right now. He just falls, he's on his back, and Barbarian is all over him. Nord the Barbarian has come back, and he doesn't care who he's got, he's just out to hurt him, hospitalize him, put him out of wrestling. He throws Boyd. Wait a minute, he just slapped somebody at ringside. He just slapped. That's Brian Adams, the American Ninja. Brian Adams in the crowd. Brian Adams coming back. He's smashing Barbarian. Now we got a fight. Now we got something a little more equalized in here. Yes, sir. Brian Adams sitting at ringside. I didn't even see him down there. Brian Adams. Barbarian reached in the crowd and he slapped Brian Adams. He didn't even know who he was hitting. He didn't know who he was slapping. He does now. He does now. Now he's got a fight on it. This is a little more evenly matched right now. Barbarian and Brian Adams, the American Ninja. Scotty, the body. What about this one, huh?
Unbelievable, boss. I can't believe it. Brian Adams, the American Ninja. North of Barbarian, size 18 feet.
Again. Look at this. Look at this. Coming off the ropes.
Like Oh, goddamn. It's breaking loose here, boss.
Hey. This is giant against giant right now, Scotty.
It's a clash of the Titans, baby. It's unbelievable.
Right hand.
Oh. People are going bananas.
Oh, they're on their feet. Here comes Buddy Rose. What's Buddy Rose doing in there? Get Buddy Rose out of there.
Over the top rope.
There's Boyd.
Wait, Jonathan Boyd got Buddy. What's Jonathan Boyd got Buddy's leg for?
The place is coming unglued. Absolutely unglued. Jonathan Boyd, Buddy Rose, Brian Adams. Nord the Barbarian. Look at this. That fight is carrying.
Brian Adams and Nord the Barbarian on the floor. Jonathan Boyd and Buddy Rose.
Look out.
And a turnbuckle. And a
back body drop.
330 pounds of Buddy Rose. Just backdrop by Jonathan Boyd. Look. A big elbow.
Look. Nord the Barbarian is choking Brian Adams with the mic cord out there.
Brian Adams picked up a big bus.
He's coming.
He's fighting back.
Man, he's fighting.
Buddy Rose is tied in the ropes. The American Ninja, Nord the Barbarian, toe-to-toe with a wire crushed around the neck.
You call one, I'll call the other.
Nord got a tear.
Wait.
Brian Adams got a tear now, too.
Buddy Rose falls outside.
Wait, there's that. Oh, they're swinging chairs at each other.
We got dueling chairs.
They're swinging chairs at each other.
This fight could carry into the crowd. They've got to be very careful.
I've never seen anything like this. This is absolutely insane. They're fighting back to the locker room.
Where are those guys going? They're going back to the dressing room. They may be going out in the parking lot.
Jonathan Boyd got some kind of sleeper on or something on Buddy Rose.
Holy moly. Yes, I can see Brian Adams is doing some damage on Nord the Barbarian.
We gotta get out of here. People at home can't see this.
We'll be right back. Right after
that. That's why you gotta come to the arena. You can't see this kind of stuff at home.
Get out of here. We gotta get out of here.
We're gonna take a break.
We're gonna take a break. This place is coming out.
Take a break, Claus. What are you doing, Claus? You can't.
Only at 159, that's Tom Peterson's.
The American Ninja, Brian Adams, are we glad to see him?
Yeah. Listen here. I now know the Barbarian is probably one of the biggest men I've been in the ring with, but Mr. Barbarian, you're not bigger than him. He's the biggest man. And he just proved that he was the toughest. And Rose, right here next week, I want to have a super tag match. Me and the American Ninja against you and Nord the Barbarian. That's what I want to hear next week.
All right. Tag Barry Owens. Can we get Barry in here? Barry, did you hear what Boyd just said? He wants a tag match, a super tag match. Brian Adams and Boyd against the team of Barbarian and Rose. What do you think about that?
Hey, I just saw what happened out here. Mr. Boyd, Brian Adams, if you want a tag match, you got it right here next Saturday night. You two men against the Barbarian and Playboy Buddy Rose right here next Saturday night.
All right. I appreciate that, Barry Owens. I sure do. But I'm going to tell you something, Rose. Next week, you and Nord the Barbarian are going to be seeing a lot of roofs because you're going to be looking up and we're going to be stomping down.
All right. We'll be right back right after this.
Salem at the WD Tire Wheel Superstore.
Yeah.
From New Jersey, introducing Scotty the Body. His opponent in this corner, 228 pounds, Beetlejuice.
Guess who my money's on? Well, I have been told that the lovely young lady in the corner, the who came in on the arm of Scotty the Body, is the beautiful Sandy. That's what I was told by none other than Scotty the Body. All right, Beetlejuice and Scotty the Body, who, hey, he professes to be the wrestling expert. And there's a nice arm drag by Scotty the Body on Beetlejuice, who professes to be nothing but a man possessed. Oh, man, this guy's something else. Hey, son of a gun. What in the world's going on here?
How you doing? Nice to be back here again.
Yeah. We have a guest commentator up here. Listen, have you ever seen anything like this? We got Scotty the Body. We got Beetlejuice. And look at this. Now, look at this. We got a nice body slam by Scotty the Body.
Woo, Benny. That's a lot of things. Oh. Well, I want to say something. You know, you be all in a LeGrand.
Wait a minute. You gotta get a formal introduction. You gotta introduce yourself formal life.
That's right. Okay. Yeah, my name is Coconut, really. Glad to be back here. You know, on the 20th, you be in LeGrand, Baker, Hunter, Burns, and you name it, baby. And I heard that another midget is in town.
There is another one?
That's right, another midget in town.
Who's that? Do you know who it is?
I don't know, but I heard it's another midget in town.
Okay, well, that he might be looking for you, Coconut Willie.
Well, let him look. I'm ready for him.
Okay, there goes Coconut. Coconut Willie making a short interview here. Into the ropes. Turnbuckle goes Scotty the Body in a beautiful, beautiful hip toss by Beetlejuice. Yes, sir. Oh, man. This crowd, they are going crazy right now. They're behind Beetlejuice. They're yelling all kinds of things at Scotty the Body. And they don't have a whole lot of love for Scotty, but I'll tell you one thing. Scotty the Body, he's got a big mouth, but he has backed that mouth up with some kind of action. The man has done some modeling. No, seriously. Not with model cars or anything, but he has done some modeling. The man was actually one of the Chippendales guys. You know what I'm talking about, ladies? Yeah, well, you're seeing one of the Chippendale men out there in the form of Scotty the Body, a backbreaker on Beetlejuice. This could be it, folks. This could be a 1-2. Beetlejuice kicks out. Now, let me tell you something. A couple of 3 months ago, when Art Barr was in there, that would have been all. But not Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice, look at the guy. He's all over. He's all over Scotty the Body. And he's putting all kinds of, marks and colors all over Scotty's body right now, too. Biting him and punching him. Now, Scotty is complaining to referee Sandy Barr. He said, look what I got all over me here. I'm not as pretty as I was when I first came in here. There's another lockup. And a knee by Scotty the Body. And a double smash by Scotty. And here comes a suplex up. And can he get him over? He's got him. He's got him over. Remember, this is all under the watchful eye of Scotty's 1-2. Beetlejuice bit him again in the stomach. A solar plexus bite by Beetlejuice. Scotty the Body has the beautiful Sandy sitting in his corner over here. And I have no idea what she's there for other than moral support. She doesn't seem to be doing much. She's not yelling at him. She doesn't seem to be encouraging him. Forearm smash by Scotty. He caught Beetlejuice right in the ear. He caught him again in the ear. Beetlejuice blocks that when he comes back with a right hand. Another right hand. And Scotty, the body, is reeling a little bit out there. He's seeing some stars, some cobwebs, a drop kick, and he took down the referee with that drop kick. Scotty, the body, ran right into referee Sandy Barr. Look at this. Beetlejuice comes back in, and he's got a head scissors on Scotty, the body. Beetlejuice, tremendous athletic ability, and he's just hanging on those ropes. And referee Sandy Barr finally getting up. He got nailed hard by Scotty the Body. A drop kick by Beetlejuice sent Scotty right into referee Sandy Barr. And now, look at this! Sandy Barr says, hey, you're disqualified, fella. You're disqualified. You ran into me. And Scotty the Body is beside himself. He said, wait a minute. I was shoved into it. Now here, he's gonna get on the PA mic here.
Over the top. He fell. He let go of himself. He was hanging on. He let go of himself. I didn't throw him over. This match is under protest.
Come on, Scotty, get your mouth working. We'll be back with more after this timeout.
Ah, I see we share a oneness for muffin and egg breakfast sandwiches brought to us by the discriminating people at AM/PM Mini Market. Have you opted for the succulence of ham or the firmly packed sausage? How does the introductory price of 99 cents grab you? Served hot and toasty, bringing you to mind, my dear.
Fill up for less on a new muffin and egg breakfast sandwich at AM/PM, now just 99 cents. Burt Lancaster, Audrey Hepburn, Audie Murphy, and Lillian Gish star in The Unforgiven, Sunday night at 5 on KBTV 12.
Beetlejuice, it looks like you got split open a little bit there.
Yeah, I got split open a little bit, but you see, I won. I won. I outsmarted the wrestling expert, Snotty the Body. You know, I got my little buddy here tonight. He's just so cute. And you know, we're both coming out here. We beat Scotty the Body. He really thinks he's such the wrestling expert.
Hey, wait a minute, punk. You know something? This is my time out here. What are you out here doing? You're bleeding up the head. You got pain all over your face. You're nothing but a young punk. You know, I've known you since you were about so high. What does your mommy and daddy think about you painting your face up like that? Who in the hell do you think you are, you little punk? You're a nobody. Come on, what's your act? You're
Beetlejuice.
Hey, don't be afraid, pal. Hey, listen, you're nothing but a punk. You're not afraid? Well, you better be afraid. Hey, you're a punk. This is my segment. This is my time. So get the hell out. Yeah, that's right. Go on. Go on, punk. Go on. Yeah. Hey, you let me tell you something, Don Koss. No pun intended. I just want to put the punk in his place. I come to the Northwest. I make my mark. But let me tell you something. I haven't made a big enough mark. What I'm going to have to do is anybody gets in my way, and you know, Don Koss, I'm not one to lay down and let nobody walk over me. Somebody gets in my face, they're going to have to face the tune. What I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to make Matt Bourne's mark. And Matt Bourne's mark is I'm going to have to take some scissors to everybody's head that I come across. So what I'm going to do is whoever Matt Bourne has to beat up, Matt Bourne's going to take a little clip off their hair. So, get in my face.
We're gonna cut you off.
I'm gonna cut some hair, and if you had any hair on the top of your head, I'd cut your hair too. So you want to get in my face a little bit? I'll cut your hair. I'm gonna cut anybody's hair that gets in my face. You understand that?
I'd love to stay here and talk with you, Matt Bourne, but we gotta get out of here. We'll be right back.
Only at Tom Peterson. Save today, 10 a.m. till 9 p.m. This 19-inch color TV, only $159. That's Tom Peterson's.
We had a friendship that was really tested and stretched to its very limits. There was a match that involved Scott Peterson and Steve Dahl, and there was an accidental mishap that occurred, and I want to show this, show a tape for you right now so you can see exactly what happened. It was an entirely as accidental, but watch this tape. We'll be right back. All right, this is our third and final fall. Oh, we're all even at one fall apiece, Scotty.
We got all four men in the ring. It turned out to be quite some match, didn't it, Dave?
It's done, Scotty.
Steve Dahlbeck, Joey Jackson, and Tomago. Oh, power slam!
Tremendous slam.
Oh, but saved by the Colonel. Saved by the Colonel.
Well, everybody's in there now. Double spot, double drop kick by the Southern Rockers of the Beard.
Double clothesline.
Yeah,
a big forearm by Steve Dahl.
They're doubling their pleasure right now. Look at this.
No.
Oh,
he just knocked out Scott Peterson onto the floor. I don't believe this. I don't believe what's going on here.
Joey Jackson ducked down, and Steve Dahl hit his partner.
I think Steve Dahl did it on purpose. I told you there was something going on.
Oh, he didn't do it on purpose. Come on.
He hit him on purpose. I told you something was going on.
These guys are, look at Scott Peterson. He is really upset.
Peterson's leaving.
He's really upset.
I'm going to go catch up with Peterson. I'll be back in a minute.
Wait a minute. Where are you going? Scotty, the body is gone. Scott Peterson is leaving. Scott Peterson is leaving. All right, that's what happened in the ring. Now let me show you what happened up here in the crow's nest when Scotty the Body got his big mouth in the way. Now let's roll this tape. You'll see what happened here.
Look at that.
What in the world is going on here?
Look at that. I told you. You see what he did?
It was an accident. He got in the way. I got in the way.
You should have heard the things he was saying about you when I was talking to him.
No. Steve, that wasn't true. That wasn't true.
Yeah, I did.
Yes.
No, come on. Hey, I was up here explaining to these people that it was my fault. I got in the way. You come up here and start pushing me around.
Well, come on now. It was an accident.
You want to settle it?
You're damn right.
Let's do it like we do all our problems right out in the ring next Saturday.
And next week I'll be there, baby. You bring what you got.
No. This can't. You guys are friends. You've been friends too long. A tag team too long. Look what you've done.
I didn't do that. Hey, Cos, I didn't do anything. And I'll tell you what. Next week, I will be the referee for this extravaganza, baby. I'm going to referee that match.
You got to be kidding. You're the one that's caused this whole thing.
Hey.
Now you can see why we're going to have a match tonight pitting Steve Dahl against Scott Peterson. And we're going to have that match right after this. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Hurry to Vancouver Portland's only five-star Ford dealer, Vancouver Ford.
We're getting ready for Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson. Now, if you tuned in late, during Buddy Rose's Rose Garden tonight, these two men, after cooler heads prevailed, got together, decided, hey, we're still friends, we're still partners. They're going to have a scientific
ladies
match refereed by Scotty the Body. Can you believe that?
Hey, next event will be one fall. Now, this match, come on, I blame Scotty the Body for creating this whole thing, which I don't appreciate, because this is one of the great teams in America.
Oh,
okay, let's...
Well, no need for introductions. Everybody knows everybody. As Steve Dahl in the white trunks, of course, and Scott Peterson in the black trunks, and referee Sandy Barr, referee Scotty the Body in the whatever things he's got on there. That's not Calvin Klein, is it? I think it's Robert Klein. All right, Scotty the Body going to referee this thing. I think that's a mistake. That is not a good thing. These two men are still friends. We're going to have a good sportsmanship-type match right now between Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson. They talked about this during the week. They got together and said, hey, look, this Snotty the Scotty the Body is he's somewhere in the ozone layer. And the good arm drags by Scott Peterson on Steve Dahl. So they know what's going on, and they are good friends. And they know that they were set up last week by Scotty the Body's mouth. Boy, I tell you, once he gets that thing going, there's no stopping it. Into the ropes goes Scott Peterson. A beautiful leapfrog by Steve Dahl. Like another leapfrog by Steve Dahl. And a hip toss by Scott Peterson. A kickoff by Steve Dahl. This is action, my friends. Arm drag. And both men just stand there looking, okay, that's all right. That's good action. Good professional wrestling action. Now what's going on? Now what's going on? Scotty the Body is saying he's accusing Steve Dahl of pulling the trunks of Scott Peters. That didn't happen. What's he doing? Nobody pulled anybody's trunks. There's a lockup, arm bar by Scott Peterson on Steve Dahl. What I'm afraid of right now is that Scotty the Body is still going to be working on breaking up this friendship and creating a really bad thing between these two men, Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson. Because if anybody can do that, this guy can do it. Scotty the Body can with his mouth. I mean, this is just, he is an agitator. He can incite a riot when there's nobody there. And Steve Dahl on Scott Peterson. Scotty the Body, what's Scotty do? It's hard to see. Is he over there? He wasn't pulling Scott Peterson's hair, was he? Then blaming Steve Dahl. I don't think that's what it was. Scotty the Body keeping a close eye. I've never seen a referee try to referee with sunglasses on, huh? He's got shades on. I mean, how can he see everything? And now he's once again accusing Steve Dahl of pulling Scott Peterson's hair. And there's no pulling of hair. The only thing that Steve Dahl's got a hold of is the left leg of Scott Peterson. Scotty the Body is forcing Steve Dahl to break. And why? He says, now you pulled the man's tights. You pulled his trunks. No way. All right, you see what this guy's doing? You see what he's doing? He's getting something. He's trying to build a fire now between these two men. He's just trying to get something started. He's very good at this. He's a past master at this. Scotty is. He's still trying to destroy this marvelous friendship between two men that these guys have been friends for years. They were wrestling as a tag team in the state of Texas. They held titles down there. Well, now Scotty takes off his sunglasses. Now maybe we can actually see what really is going on. Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson, did you ever think you'd see a match like this? These two men battling each other, but it's a good scientific match, good sportsmanship type match. Arm bar applied by Scott Peterson on Steve Dahl. Arm drag by Dahl, and Peterson hangs on. And now Scotty the Body's accusing Scott Peterson of pulling Steve Dahl's hair. There's no hair pull. What Scotty's doing, he's pulling both of their legs is what he's doing. There's no pulling of hair. There is, however, pulling of legs. Come on, what's with this guy? Get him out of there. They need Sandy Barr in here to referee. They need Nord the Barbarian would be a better referee in there right now than Scotty the Body. He's the last guy that Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson need around them. Not at all. A good clean break, as it should be, and it is. Steve Dahl, Scott Peterson, circling each other, moving in. There's a lockup. And now a body slam by Scott Peterson. Elbow drop, misses. And Steve Dahl rolled out of the way, and Scott Peterson kind of hurt the old elbow right there. Don't forget tomorrow, Pendleton. Monday, LeGrand. Tuesday, Baker. Wednesday, Ontario. Thursday, Burns. Friday, Eugene. Mark this down. Tuesday, the 28th of March. A big, big Tuesday. Portland spectacular right here at the Sports Arena. Leapfrog by Steve Dahl. Drop kick by Steve Dahl. Down goes Peterson. You know, things are starting, I think, to get a little fired up here. I don't know how scientific this match is going to remain, especially with Scotty the Body in there. There's another lockup, and it's Steve Dahl against the turnbuckle. Boy, watch this very carefully, because this thing could get out of hand. Now, look at this. Scott Peterson is laying it into Steve Dahl. Dahl into the turnbuckle, and Dahl moves, and Peterson hits that turnbuckle hard with his shoulder. And he's looking around as if to say, hey, buddy. Is that what a friend does? There's a lockup. Arm bar by Steve Dahl on Scott Peterson. These men have trained together. They have worked out together. I don't know. I sense this is a little more than just a workout. I don't think this isn't just a training session here. Arm bar by Steve Dahl. Scott Peterson. Look at Look at Scotty the Butter. Now, his mouth is moving in there. It's motoring in there, and you don't know what he's saying to these two guys. Small package, a roll up by Scott Peterson. Two count, and Steve Dahl kicks out. Boy, that was quick. That was quick. That takes a lot of athletic ability on both men's parts, Steve Dahl and Scott Peterson. Peterson for rolling him up, and Dahl for getting out from that inside cradle or small package. There's a backslide. Scott Peterson going to go for a backslide. Steve Dahl fighting it. Now the test of strength is on. Who's going to get the backslide on the other? Steve Dahl fighting back. Peterson, of course, outweighs Steve Dahl. Peterson would have the strength over Dahl, and he's got him down. One, two, and whoa, what kind of a count is that? What kind of... Man, we got a machine gun out there counting. Scotty the Body. That was not one Mississippi. Uh-uh. Man, that was Rapid City. And a roll-up by Steve Dahl. And now a reversal roll-up by Scott Peterson. And he's got it. Now, I didn't see exactly what happened. I don't think there were any... Scotty pulled. Did we get that on camera? Scotty pulled the tights. Scotty pulled the tights, and Steve Dahl is saying, hey, you pulled the tights. And Peterson said, I didn't pull any tights. Steve Dahl said, you pulled my trunks. You were there. You pulled my trunks. Steve Dahl did not see Scotty the Body pull the trunks. I told you, the man just didn't give up. He was going to start something. Look at the smirk on Scotty's face. Scott Peterson is leaving that ring thinking that Steve Dahl pulled his tights to win the match. That was not what happened. They're coming up here in the crow's nest. We're going to keep it right here. We're going to take the microphone over here for the interview. I hope I have a chance to explain to Scott Peterson that Scott, your trunks were not pulled by Steve Dahl.
I don't know what it's
called. Hey, damn, Mike Cross, beat it.
Hey, what are you talking
about? What's going on here?
I don't know. You said I pulled your tights.
Hey, last week you leave me out there in the middle of the ring. This week you pulled on my tights, man.
I didn't pull your tights, man. I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, what's the deal? We're your best friends. Now you're just in there lying to my face.
You calling me a liar, boy?
That's what I'm calling you.
He's calling you
I'm
a liar.
The way I
He's
see
calling
it.
You a liar.
Well, I'm going to tell you something, boy. You don't see very well. Because I didn't pull your tights. And now you're calling me a liar. Hey, brother, suppose my tights out there.
Hey,
I don't know how it happened.
Hey, we don't want to see you guys acting like this to each other. Neither do the fans.
You
know these fans love
about?
You.
You called me a liar.
He called you a liar.
Hey.
Yeah, sure, we've been friends for a long time. But you, of all people, ought to know I don't lie to you.
Hey, hang on.
He's calling you a liar.
Hang on, hey.
Hey, he's just mad because you beat him.
Huh? You still feel the same way, boy?
Hey, come on.
What's doing all right now? Come on.
Hey.
Come on, tough guy.
Hey, if you guys want to act like this,
come on, baby.
Come on. You guys really want each other?
Come on, boy.
Hey, listen up. I got a contract right here for a special Tuesday extravaganza right here at the Sports Arena on the 28th. If you want it, you sign it.
The contract, pal, the contract's right here. Right here, Peterson. Here's the contract, Peterson. What's
sign
the matter?
It, boy.
Scared to sign it, Dahl? Scared to sign it?
Hey, look, Scotty.
Hey, come on, chicken. You scared to sign it?
Yeah. We've been friends too long. You called me a liar.
You look a little scared there, Dahl. You look a little scared, Pally. I don't think you got the guts to take on Scott Peterson. He just beats you in the middle of the ring.
Come on, baby.
Yes, the contract. Here you go, Barry Owens. Woo-hoo. He called you a liar. No one calls you a liar, Scott Peterson.
Why, I hope you're proud of yourself now. You see what you did? Those two men, it was a marvelous friendship they had. You pulled the tights. Everybody saw that.
You know something, Carl? You're trying to help somebody, and they always turn their back on you, like Carl Stiles, for instance. He starts listening to the people, and you know, he ain't real smart. He's only got one eye, and he ain't got no brain.
I should have known he turned his back on me, because one time I met his family, you know, and his old mama, she don't have but one eye either, and she ain't real smart either. Matter of fact, his whole family is real dumb, you know, and they all got just one eye, just like that stupid Carl Stahl. Well, I tried to help him. You can't help some people. Some people can't help. He turns his back on me. Starts listening to the fans.
Wait a minute. Hold it. I'm tired of you talking about my family, and I'm tired of you talking about my eye. We ain't gonna wait till no TV's off. We gonna fight now.
No, you can't. No, not out here. This is not supposed to be on television. We can't start it now.
This is great, Cause. This ain't supposed to be on TV. I can't believe this. Carl Stahl is going after his former mentor, the grappler.
No, this can't be happening. This can't be happening. The match is starting right now. Styles and the grappler. Look at this. He's extending him above. Look at that power. Look at that strength.
We got up here. Sticks are going. The fans are going bananas here, Don Cause.
We got to get out of here because this cannot be on television. This match cannot be on television. It's not suited for TV.
I'll tell you what, I don't care if there's TV time. The people at home are going to get to see it. They're lucky to be watching Don Owens promotion because nobody else would show this match on TV.
Listen, what? You're just a troublemaker. Why don't you go out there and get in the middle of them right now?
Hey, they're doing just fine by themselves, baby. This is one heck of a match. And you know, I tell you, I hope it doesn't end before TV goes, so the people don't have to miss the end of the match. They'll serve them right for not showing up at the arena.
We've got the teacher going against the trainer, the coach, and the grappler taking the leg out from under Carl Stiles. This is not supposed to be on television. We're not supposed to be here right now. It was not supposed to start up here in the Crow's Nest. They fought all the way out through the crowd into the ring. Look at that. Wrapping his leg around that iron post. Grappler working on Carl Stiles. And now he's just twisting that left leg around the post.
He's trying to tear the ligaments. The grappler's going to tear the ligaments off of Carl Stiles.
I hope you're able to mark down Tuesday, March 28th. Steve Dahl, Scott Peterson, and thanks to Scotty, the body is going to be Dahl and Peterson out there.
Hey, don't you worry about that. That's already set, baby. But right now, the grappler's going to work on Carl Stiles' leg, baby. He's going to... Carl Stiles, I tell you what, he's got a lot of nerve claiming he's going to take the boot off, claiming he's going to unmask the grappler. He's getting his just desserts right now, baby.
Next Saturday night, mark it down, get your tickets early and be here. This place is going to be packed, it's going to be jumping. We've got two giants. We got Nord the Barbarian teaming up with Buddy Rose to go against the American Ninja, Brian Adams.
Oh, brutal clothesline by Carl Stiles. The grappler's reeling, Don Cause.
Yes, he is. He is rocking and reeling now, and Stiles working on him. It's going to be Adams teaming up with Jonathan Boyd in a tremendous tag match next Saturday. Look at he's taking that boot off. He's taking that so-called, look at that.
The man's handicapped. He's going for the man's handicap. I can't believe it. That'd be like the grappler going after Carl Stiles. Good. I don't believe I'm seeing this.
Look at this. He's just pulling up the whole ring. Stiles is going to take that boot off of him, and he's going to destroy the boot. Watch this. Nobody.
He's got no right, Don Cause. He's got no right to go for the man's handicap. The man was crippled since he was a child. It's not fair. It's a travesty. I don't believe this.
I'll tell you, he's about as crippled as your mouth. That is not fair. Look at that. He's got it off. Carl Stiles has got the boot off the grappler. Now he's going to go for the mask. He's going to go for the mask next.
See, that's what shows how dumb Carl Stiles is. He got the boot off, and he didn't use it against the grappler. But now he's going for the mask. He's trying to tear the mask off.
He's tearing that mask. Look, his hair sticking out through the top of the mask. Now he's going to use that boot. Look at that. Huh?
He's loading the boot. He's loading. I mean, it's not. Oh!
Right across the face. The grappler is out of the ring. Where's he going? He's heading back to the dressing room, Scotty.
No, the grappler won't do that. He'll be back. I'm telling you, the grappler won't run from anyone. Not especially not Carl Stiles.
Stiles is going back there after him. Stiles is going to carry this match out into the parking lot. If he has to, this is absolutely pandemonium. I can't believe what's going on here.
He got the boot. He got that orthopedic boot. And he used it against his mentor, his coach. I can't believe Carl Stiles will resort to such a lowly tactic like that.
And he's got half the mask off. You saw him tear. I mean, he didn't bother trying to take it off. He was tearing that mask off.
He used a knife to cut it open. That's how he got the top split. He used a knife. He's using foreign objects. He should be disqualified.
He didn't use a knife. He used his hands. That power and strength in his hands.
He could have ripped that mask. There's no way. If Sandy Barr should disqualify. Hey, what's Sandy Barr doing with that boot in the ring?
Yeah, he's checking it for foreign objects. I'll tell you, that's what he's doing. Huh? That so-called boot that he loads all the time. The grappler has loaded that boot, and he has about ended careers of pro wrestlers with that boot.
No, he hasn't. That boot's very illegal. Sandy Barr has no right to be fondling and checking that boot. He has no right. He should put it down. It's not his property.
This place is going crazy. Absolutely crazy. Look at this. Carl Stiles, he yanked the door off the dressing room. He yanked the door off the dressing room, and he's got the door out in the ring right now.
I hope Don Owens is going to make him pay for it.
Man, look at this. Look at this, Stiles. What's Stiles going to do? What in the world is he doing with the door? This place is absolutely gone crazy. People
are under. Grappler, this ain't over yet. There ain't no door between Stiles. You come on out here, and you can finish this, boy.
I don't know. Hey, if the grappler's smart, he's going to stay wherever he is.
Keep your eyes, boy. You understand? Anybody got a saw?
Yeah,
Anybody got a saw?
He wants to saw that boot up.
He's got no right. That's private property.
Here comes the grappler. Here comes the grappler after his boot and after Stiles. Look at this. Hold it. There's Nord the Barbarian. The Barbarian's getting in the ring. What's he doing? Grappler's bleeding. And look, Stiles is bleeding. Nord the Barbarian and Grappler. This can't be.
We've got a beard stick there. It's all breaking down. Nord the Barbarian. There's blood covering the Grappler. They got the door. They're going to clothesline him with the door.
No.
Goodbye. Goodbye, Carl Stiles.
I can't believe this. They just laid that door on him, and Barbarian comes crashing down on the door.
320 pounds. Three out of again. Again, they're going to bury Carl Stiles in the middle of the ring.
This could be the end of a career. This could be the end of the career of Carl Stiles. The grappler just leveled Sandy Barr, the referee. What in the world is going on? Barbarian, the giant, the grappler out there attacking Stiles, attacking the referee. Here comes Scott Peterson. Peterson's in there. He's working on the grappler. The grappler throws him outside. Oh, my gosh. I've never seen anything like this at the arena.
Barbarian's coming off the top rope with the door.
Here comes Brian Adams, the American Ninja. Brian Adams coming in there. They need him in there.
He's taking the ropes. Nord the Barbarian lost his balance. He's following the door. And Brian Adams is in the house of fire, baby.
Can you believe this? There's Top Gun. Everybody's in there. Brian Adams and the Barbarian going at it. Grappler and Top Gun. Stiles is still on his back.
It's unbelievable. Everybody's open. Peterson's on the floor. And Nord the Barbarian kicks Danny Barr. Brian Ninja nails the Grappler.
I can't believe what's happening out there, Scotty. Look at Brian Adams. He's pulverizing the ground.
Oh, no, the Barbarian from behind. He nailed the American Ninja. He's got him choking over the top rope. And the grappler's back on top of Carl Stiles. He's choking him out. Here comes Jonathan Boyd.
This is absolutely too brutal. It's too violent. This cannot be on television. It wasn't supposed to be on TV. We've got to get out of here.
No, we can't. It's pure mayhem. Jonathan Boyd. Oh, he just had part of the grapple.
This is going to get way. It's out of hand now. It's going to get uglier. And we've got to get out of here. This wasn't supposed to be on TV at all.
That's what the people get for not coming to the arena to see it themselves, for being too cheap to spend the money.
Ladies and gentlemen, be here next Saturday night. That tremendous tag team action. We've got to get out of here. This is Don Cross from the Portland Sports Arena, the House of Action. This has been Portland Wrestling. See you next Saturday night.